Hey guys, we're back with more Roman Empire EU3, and this could actually be, depending on how far I get, it could be the last part of this Let's Play. We'll also have to see how far I get, but that's certainly not a inconceivable thing to say. This could be the last part of the Let's Play. So rebellions. Okay. Yeah, I mean, it's, and we've had a good run and everything, but it's, when someone said this, someone said get rid of, the idea, they said it on, like, part set 117, ecumenism, because it, all it's gonna do is, cause me more and more, conversions. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get rid of that and go for, let me think. Go for Let me see this. Esprit de Corps. We'll take an infamy hit, but you know what? It's worth it to stop getting all these rebellions and everything. Not rebellions, but conversions. And we recover stability decently quickly, so we'll be just fine. I'll wait till my stability comes back up, and then I might do something with my armies, with their newfound esprit de corps. And of course, all during this time, I will just deal with these rebels that keep popping up. I don't know how they keep coming up. I mean, sure, they're being incited by foreign nations, but what the frick? They're being incited by foreign nations, but at the same time, there's no, people there that want, ooh, that's good. There's no foreign nations that really want to, that's a lot of places that just cored. There's no foreign nations that, want to, what am I saying? There's no one in these colonies that wants to revolt in the first place. So how can they fund people who don't want to revolt? And I don't even understand. It's crazy. Anyway, we take these people out with this new general that I put on here. He's a great general. Hopefully he'll take out these Roman Patriculus, whatever they're called. Support the philosopher as always. Philosophy over religion any day. Alright, come on. Take him out. What? That's crazy. Catalonia exists. That's a, Aragonese nation. The Aragonese are Catalonian, so I don't really understand quite why they make the distinction between the two nations in a way, but, they are separate nations. And, of course, we've got more rebellions now. We have more rebellions. Come on, save. Poland, Korbach, is under siege. Alright. Speaking of sieges, I'm going to move that down. There we go. You, my friends, go back there. This time, we should be able to completely take them out. Let's watch this. Keep this guy, he's pretty good. Actually, we can probably get a new guy now. I'll get a new guy soon for my leader next year. I will. All right, missionaries to send. I'll start converting Europe if I can. Europe and the more western places. I want to keep them as orthodox as possible. But now we can actually spread orthodoxy even further. But if you look at it, our tolerance is still very high of heretics. It's even higher than, oops. It's even higher than our tolerance of the true faith, which is kind of weird. And we apparently like heathens better than we like the true faith, which is once again very, very weird. I don't quite understand how that's actually at all possible, but oh well. I guess you could say we're very much a we're almost a secular nation, almost. We're not a secular nation only because we actively fund missionaries. But that's only for the reason that I like my nation. I like my maps to look uniform, you know. And you gotta imagine that within the Byzantine Empire, there'd be some resentment toward Catholicism. And by extension, Protestantism, which was a branch off of Catholicism. I never quite made the dream of the Mediterranean as an Italian lake, or as a Roman lake, quite true, but it was close enough to me. I'm satisfied with how far we made it in that dream. If we funded that, we would be finished in... We will never get another thing of land tech, I don't think. I think we're done with getting land tech. Alright. Still way ahead in tech. Best, you know, most technologically advanced nation in the world right now. We have another missionary to send. Yeah, I think that, whoever told me about that, thing where, you know, if you have ecumenism, I mean, whatever it's called, you get, conversions. Thank you for telling me about that, because, I will now know to not ever take that in the future, because I don't like conversions. And our infamy is almost zero, so we should probably do something with the armies, but honestly, I'm just, happy to let the game kind of run out as it is. I think I'm happy with our empire as it is. The size, the shape, the makeup. Actually, what we need to industrialize. It's going to cost a lot of money. We'll lose 5 stability. You know what? We're going to industrialize. In the long run, it's going to help, but in the short term, ooh, it hurts. Ooh, it hurts. All right. Now look at our revolt risk. Skyrocketed everywhere. It'll skyrocket even more, I think, in a second. Now we're going to get revolt risks for a while, or revolts everywhere for a while in this place. In Biotzi. All right, we can deal with these. Yeah, you guys go back here. Like I said, we're gonna have some bad revolts for a while, but May of next year it'll be good. So, come on. I really should turn off the autosave while I'm recording, because it takes so long to autosave. It doesn't take that long, but it takes longer than I believe it should. But we are now an industrialized nation, so we'll probably, you know... I mean, it's a good thing that we've industrialized. Let's see. Production efficiency, tax modifier, technology cost. Yeah, it's a good thing overall that we've industrialized. Legio 1. There we go. The Classis one. Yep, we have the Classis one, and no Classis 2, but we have the Classis de Islas. Which no one's corrected me on my Latin yet, so I'm assuming that it's correct. So, in the waning years of the EU3 campaign, we are sending conversions to unify our empire under one faith. We are sending... the heck? Don't stop responding. It stopped responding. Ugh. Of course, right after I say I should turn off autosaving, the game crashes. So, I guess that's an incentive to not turn off autosaving, because we only had to go back a few months. So that's a good thing. I mean, you know, I'm glad that I didn't have to go back further than that. We get 2 rebellions here, one here, one here, then head back there. There we go. Like I said, we're going to have some revolt problems for a while. That's only because, even though out here, for whatever reason, we've not got... See, because tolerance... because the tolerance is higher here of foreign faiths, it actually brings it down more, and it just doesn't make any sense. It's crazy. Where did that rebellion come up? Right there? Okay. Okay, yeah, okay, fine. And now we're getting some more pirates coming out. So, Founding Father and Bone, alright, can't do us any harm. See, I don't know what kind of independent nation they'd have in Bone, so, you know, it's kind of crazy. Now you, Mr. Navy. Mr. Navy. Classis 1. Classis Unum. Nope, I don't want to gain a core in Russia. I like Russia. They're my friend. Though we're not actually on the best of terms right now, because they... We are on good terms, but they, they, what's the word? They, refuse to come to us in any war. I'm Brachna Aragon. See, I'm not gonna use it. I'm not gonna use it. I've already got a core on there. Brachna would just be, right there. I'm gonna sell the issue. I'm not gonna use it because I don't plan on, I honestly don't plan on expanding that much more in this game. It's just, at this point, I think I'm just gonna kinda cut my losses and stay where I am. Not cut my losses, but, just stay where I am and, you know, be happy with where I am. I think it's, but they're giving me all these cores that I could, you know, 100 years ago I could have used. Now they're worthless to me because I'm not... if you guys watch this series for the war, you can stop watching it right now. Because I don't think I'm going to go to war for the rest of the series. Which is... No, not that. Which is probably just going to be this video, to be honest. So, if you want to see war, don't watch this video. If you want to see the ending days of the Roman Empire... Not ending days, but, the ending, time of the Roman Empire, when our infamy is almost down to zero, we're not hated throughout the entire world. Now is when we start improving our relations with everyone. We start, you know, hey, we're gonna boot this guy out of, office. We want to be more, more loving, not loving, but, more friendly towards everyone. More, more accepting of other countries and whatnot. Even though, actually, we're very accepting already. We just don't like other countries, existing. But we're accepting of their cultures, we just don't like them existing. Which I find kind of funny, but... But yeah, cheers on the dude who, I'll do that. On the dude that said, ecumenism was the problem with the rebellions. Because I will most certainly not, ever take that idea again, because I didn't know that it did that. I did not know that that was the case. Alright. Our vote risk is still pretty high. I mean, it's not that high. We have industrialism still affecting it, but it's not a big deal. It'll be fine. Gain 2 base tax. We want a... Angelos ruler. It's pretty the exact same stats. Wow. But yeah, that's gonna start our. I'm gonna pretend that was our policy to start reaching out towards European nations that previously have hated us, and kind of reconcile ourselves. We wanted a more open policy, and not open borders, but open arms policy against other European nations. Especially the ones that have always hated us. Bohemia, Netherlands, all those kind of people. I want to improve my relations with them. Just because I can. You know, it's a new era, kind of. Got to improve stability. We're moving into another... Pax Romana. I think that for the next beautiful statue, the common heritage of mankind is richer for it. All right. We're entering another Pax Romana where there's peace, there's understanding. You know, it's a very tolerant time, a very good time. It's the end of an era, in a way, but in a good way. We're going to start helping our allies, helping our friends, helping our enemies. Now, I could come up with some reason for why this is coming about, why the nation starts feeling this way, but I'm going to go with there was some kind of national event that opened our eyes to the injustice of the world or some crap like that, and now we're want to be accepting. What we wanted to do all along is unite everyone under one nation, but we realize that that's unfeasible, and you know, the manifest destiny has been in a way completed, so now we're going with peace and love and understanding and crap like that. So that's my story, and I'm sticking to it. I think it makes it for a very interesting end game scenario that, oop, not that, don't cancel, you know, all of a sudden we would just stop hating everyone. I think that's a very interesting scenario. Trying to improve our relations with these people by sending them money, you know, becoming their friends again. Now the Netherlands are no longer hating us. We've only got 5 more years in the game, folks, and I think we're going to get past that in this video. I think we're going to. It's the Papal State. You know, we can even rectify our relations with the Papal State. You know? Keep this guy. He's going to be the great diplomat. Angelos the diplomat. Denmark will release... Whoa! Should we add... Oh, that's bad for Denmark. Yep, we're not seeing Scandinavia united anytime soon. Sweden doesn't hate us. Sweet, so before they start hating us, we can send them gifts, make an ally out of them. That is very good. Alright, we got a bunch of cores out here. It's good, it's a good time. We're pushing Muslims back, and by Muslims I mean they're a lot of their more evil ideals. Not that Christians are really much better, but by this point, in the 1800s, I think the Christians were pretty docile compared to the Muslims at this point. Though I wouldn't call Christians docile even today. If you look at the Westboro Baptist Church and their ilk, then you can see that Christians are not too docile even today. Ooh, yeah, royal marriage. Sweet. Alright, now I'm gonna... Yeah, you guys, royal marriage, likely sweet. Maybe an alliance or two. Throwing that out there. Royal marriage, very unlikely. No, they still don't like us. They still don't like us. But we can throw a few gifts their way. Or wait, Horde has the Civil War. That is the second time I've seen this. I've seen that event in this game. And apparently it's very rare. So... Civil War going on. It's interesting. Offer alliance. Unlikely. Send a gift. We got some royal marriages going on all throughout Europe. Send you another gift. There we go. Converted the heretics of Cox. I know it's not Cox. It's Caw, I think. I'm going to call it Cox, though. Cox is a funny name. Because it sounds like male genitalia. Anyway, I'm going to keep sending my men to places, my missionaries. Boundary dispute on Bohemia. You know what? 100 years ago, would have been nice. But settle issue. I'm done expanding for now. Now... If I wanted to, I could probably continue this game all the way up through Victoria 2 and Hearts of Iron 2 or 3, but I'm not going to do that. I could, you know, keep playing as these guys up until the mid-1950s. I'm not going to do it. It's just, and this is the end of the era of the Roman Empire. Not, I mean, like, you know, of their warring era. Production stifled. That's good, okay. Romandois is converted. But yeah, we're getting some good conversions now. I'm never taking that idea again. Ecumenism. Actually, I have an idea that I've been wanting to play as the Papal State for a while. No, not that. No, not war. War is bad. I've been wanting to play as the Papal State for a while, just because I was interested in them. And I think that I was going to take that because, you know, they're a very Catholic nation, but I could, you know, play a very tolerant... Spain lost some land to Tripoli, which is kind of sad, all things considered. Look at their tech level. But, what's it called? I was going to say something. And now I forgot. Oh, yeah, I was going to play as the Papal State, and I could, I was going to take that because I could be a very, you know, tolerant Papal State, but now that I think about it, if that's going to make a bunch of places convert, that's not what I'd want as a Papal State. I'd want a Catholic Europe. So I think that, so, in the Papal State game that I'm going to play, my goal isn't going to be a large amount of area, a large empire, though that'll probably end up happening. It's going to be a, the goal is going to be a, they're allied with these people, at war with no one. Interesting, okay. And the Incas just won a war against Quito. But, I could, you know, like, only play it as a theological nation. Ah, and the Inca won against the Spanish down here. Interesting. Chile exists. Chile is right here. So yeah, all of the American nations are starting to come around a little bit. I'm so glad that the Inca actually survived. That's awesome. Ansbach still hates us. Right now I'm trying to, you know, like, improve my relations with everyone. And it's slowly working. Within, you know, several hundred years, we'd probably be pretty good with everyone. You know, our national standing would probably be pretty high. I think it would be pretty good, you know, in a short amount of time. I want to keep improving relations, of course. Offer alliance, unlikely, but we'll keep trying. You guys, offer alliance, unlikely, but, you know, we'll keep sending gifts. They love us now. They love us. All right. We're almost in We are almost in the 1818, so that'll be good. Sending missionaries everywhere, trying to consolidate our nation, make it a more better place for everyone. Brandenburg hates us. And you know what? We're going to try to reconcile with the Holy Roman Empire. You know, there's the Roman Empire and the Holy Roman Empire. We are going to kind of say, you know what? There's no need for this divide between the Roman Empire and the Holy Roman Empire. They can be the Roman Empire of the North with the Roman Empire of the South. And maybe one day we'll reconcile with each other completely, form into one nation, and it'll be good. At least that's the thing that I'm going with. Whether or not we actually ever do that, we won't know because the game ends in only a few years. So we won't really ever get a chance to see that. UPCA. Ubka. And Kanek. That's cool. And Yusa has some land down here. Yusa. Good old Yusa. Connect, I'm guessing, is a, yeah, look, they're, Mayan cultured, sweet! Another Mayan culture exists, the UPCA. I don't know what that stands for, but, they're a revolutionary republic. So, yeah, the, Europeans are slowly being pushed out of America. America! But, what is that? Is that Vietnam? Like, where modern Vietnam would be? This place. It is. That is, Vietane. I'm guessing that's meant to be Vietnam. Maybe not. I don't know. But they're worth Hindustan, so they're not gonna last too long. Not gonna last long at all. Alright. We got some guys to send to convert. Got some rebellions. We used to have a core in this place, I remember that, but it's gone now. It's kind of weird to think about France still exists. They're just such a non-entity in the world that, it's kind of crazy. I kind of want those, you know, those patriots and rebels to win. They're ruled by a German king. It's not even really France anymore, it's just a sham of a country. But, you know, we'll see. I doubt anything will come of... Yeah, they're being sieged again. Nothing's going to come of their short-lived independence. Not even building any armies. So sad. Oh, well. Aha, we get into the diplomat annexing Wales. Sweet. Sweet. I annexed Wales. I got some revolt risk there, but that's to be expected. So we'll have to move our navy over there. So that we don't get overrun with rebellions over there. Now we need to increase our stability. So, you know what? The Roman Empire now spreads. You know, we've retaken part of the British Isles. So you know what? I'm happy with that. Royal marriage, unlikely. No, they still hate us. Actually, they like us now, but they just not our best friends in the world. How about I give military access? There we go. Do that. I need the diplomat. Netherlands, royal marriage with Russia. But Beethoven, no. I like Beethoven. That's sad. Oh well. I'm sure we have enough men anyway. Anyway, folks, now we're 2 years away from the end of the game. So you know what? We're definitely going to end it up this part. We are coming to, you know, the end of an era of Roman imperialism. Now it's the Pax Romana, where Rome is focused on peace, understanding, humanism, that kind of thing. You know, really, letting people do whatever the hell they want. More, freedom. Though we're still very mercantilist. I'm gonna just give you guys a spoiler, and that is that if this game were to continue, we would forgo our mercantilist policies and go become more free trade-ish. But Haiti exists in Cuba. So Haiti exists in Cuba. So that's weird. But good for them, I guess. They're Dutch. So that's good for them, I guess. It's good for them. Now we got another conversion guy to send. To burn. There we go. But yeah, you can walk from Khuzestan to okay, maybe you can't walk because you have to get over here, but you can pretty much get from Khuzestan to the Atlantic Ocean without ever walking over somewhere that's not Orthodox, which I think is a pretty good accomplishment. I've seen people do better, but you know what? I'm not one of those people that cares too much about being like the best player in the world, so I'm not too concerned with it. Philosopher. You know, we need a good philosopher. We do need a good philosopher. Cultural tradition, as always. We got a little bit of infamy for something. I don't know what we got infamy for, but... Oh, well, actually, you know what? I'm going to take these guys back and deal with these pirates. There we go. Rebellions be damned. So now, the whole point of this is to be, not lead the world by military might, but lead the world by, might of, you know, cultural stuff, and, you know, culturalism, and being a very, understanding and good nation, like, I don't know, I'm trying to think of a good modern day example, but I can't really think of any. England annexed Louisiana. Yep, sucks for them. But anyway, folks, we're in the last year of the game. It's kind of crazy. In 1820, unless the mod extends the timeline, which I don't think it does yet. I don't think it does that yet. So we'll see. Come on, I don't want any rebellions at the end of the game. There we go. Ah, send some more of these guys to Zurich. Very nice city, by the way. I know I've said that before. It's a very nice city. All our generals are dying, and I'm not planning to recruit anymore because I'm not going to need them. And in December, I'm going to save, and then we're going to play to the end of the game. And then, folks, this game's over. This game is over. You know what? Support free trade. That's the first time we're going towards free trade, and it's all because of our new king. He's a very, our new Caesar. He's laissez-faire. He's a very free guy, you know, free subjects, free trade, that kind of thing. Anyway, I'm going to save it today on the 1st of December. Let's play. And several hundred years after the founding of the Roman Republic, which was on January 1st, 1587, I believe, and the founding of the Roman Republic, and the Roman Empire was founded 10 years before that. The game is over, folks, unless it continues after this day, in which I will feel really stupid. I will feel really stupid if it doesn't end here, because I've been propping this up. Oh, end game, there we go. Is the year of our Lord, 1820. The revolutionary era has passed, and now the long 19th century is in progress. What changes has your nation seen in the last 400 years? Quit. And here, folks, is a history of our empire by rulers. I'll go through all of them real quick. Manuel II, I loved him. He was amazing. Ioannis VII, amazing. Regency Council. Constantinos the 11th, I don't remember him. Andronicus V, Manuel III, was boring. Ruled for only 3 years. And then the Regency Council ruled for only a few days. Andreas I, I think I remember him. Theodoros I, Andronicus VI, Ioannis VIII, Constantinos XII, Manuel IV, Andronicus Komnenos. You know, this is the senatorial the beginning of the Republic, Andronikos Komnenos becomes the first consul. Jason Rangby, this guy, another Komnenos, another one of those guys. Gabras, Batiziz, I remember him. Don't remember him. All these guys. I remember him. I remember him. Philippos Komnenos, I remember him. Yeah, a lot of the... I remember that guy. He was good. A lot of the guys are easy to... he's pretty good, too. A lot of the guys are easy to forget because you haven't been for either such a short time or they do so little. Don't remember him. Getting close to the end of the game now, folks. And this guy, Chrysanthos Angelos, was the... probably the... he's the current ruler of our nation. Current being... Agent 21, but folks, that, if it doesn't stop responding, hold on, okay, it didn't stop responding, it almost did. Anyway, folks, thank you so much for watching this Let's Play from the beginning to the end. Hopefully you watched all the parts. Let's get ready for Skyrim. Yeah! And that's gonna be the next Let's Play. And, we'll see, but that's not the end of EU3. We will see some more EU3. Relatively soon. And I'm gonna surprise you guys with what I'm gonna do. Yeah, I don't think you'd ever predict this, what I'm gonna do. It's kind of a surprise. So, as always, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. And I hope to see you next time. Thanks for watching, folks.